TSXV listed Avrupa Minerals is active in three European countries. It is so in Portugal, in Kosovo, and in Germany. And it's very active in forming joint venture partners to push forward its exploration program. Joining us now is President and Chief Executive Paul Kuhn. Paul, welcome.
Morning, Jeremy. Thank you. Thanks for having me.
It's a pleasure to talk to you because you're one of these companies that makes a lot out of joint ventures in your projects. I know that you're very active at the moment in Portugal. Tell us a little bit about this flagship asset we've got.
Well, we're a prospect generator. We're the only true European prospect generator working in Europe, based in Europe. Portugal is our main focus at the moment, and we have a large joint venture with Antofagasta Minerals in the pyrite belt of southern Portugal. We're looking for copper there.
You're also looking for tungsten as well.
We're looking for tungsten in the north of Portugal. Our partner there is Blackheath Resources, Canadian junior but very experienced in tungsten exploration.
Mm. Let's talk about the deal, the joint venture you have with Antofagasta for the copper first of all. Tell us what you're doing and what the joint venture partnership means for investors.
Well, the joint venture with Antofagasta is a copper exploration program in a 2,000-year-old mining belt. Antofagasta is a Chilean-based copper producer. They are exploring for copper all around the world, and we're one of their better projects. We've got a three-year drill program that we've just completed, and we're starting on our fourth year in January. They've funded us to the tune of about $4.5 million U.S. so far. And we're drilling starting in January. The project there is looking for copper-rich massive sulfide deposits, and we feel that our partnership has got as good a chance of finding copper as anybody there. The value to the shareholders is that we're doing major exploration with a major copper producer, and they're funding us.
That's good news for anybody at Mines of Money this year. One of the things, of course, is the funding issue. And if you don't have the money or don't have the partnership, it's very difficult.
We're looking at funding a little bit differently in that we're, rather than going to the market every 3 months or whatever, we're trying to use our partners' funding for advanced exploration to hopefully develop or find and develop a mine, which then brings shareholder value through royalties or profits from the mine. Mm.
Talk a bit about the tungsten asset as well in Portugal.
Tungsten is called Covash, the Covash joint venture in northern Portugal. It's a formerly producing tungsten mine. Our partner Blackheath Resources has been involved in tungsten in Portugal before this, and they're a very aggressive partner. They're funding us approximately €1 million so far. We're drilling right now, and we anticipate having results out in a month or so from our work there.
Mm. What about the rest of the assets that you've got? Because I know that Portugal is, as I said, your flagship asset, your flagship location.
Portugal is our flagship. We've got 9 licenses in Portugal. We've got four other pyrite belt licenses that we're aiming to joint venture, hopefully at this meeting. We've got an iron oxide copper gold target near the pyrite belt in southern Portugal, which we also hope to joint venture. We have Kosovo, 5 assets in Kosovo, one of which is a very interesting gold property called Slivovo, and we're anticipating a joint venture there in the next few weeks. We have in Germany, we have an old mining district called the Erzgebirge project. It's been mined for about 1,000 years from the Saxon time to the modern times, and we're looking for gold in Germany. Gold, but we've also discovered a bit of tin potential on the southern part of our project there. So it's a buy project, two heads. One's tin, which is quite attractive at the moment, and one's gold, which has never been looked for in Germany.
You had a successful fundraising, didn't you, in October, just a short while ago?
We did. We raised a total of about $900,000, including a private part of the deal with Callinan Royalties, who are funding us for grassroots exploration in Portugal and on one of our licenses in order to attract new joint ventures. We're very pleased that they're supporting us as well.
Well, the support is very important. How do you gauge the markets at the moment for mining companies?
Tough.
Yeah.
It's not easy. However, this prospect generator model is a good way to weather this these bad times. We don't have a lot of money. We have 500,000 or so in the bank right now, but we're moving ahead at full speed. We've got two drill projects going on. We've got an exploration program going on. So we're able to move forward with our funding joint venture partners. And basically, for every dollar we've raised in the markets, we're able to spend more than $1.50 through our partnerships. So it's pretty efficient in these low times.
Give us a couple of headlines to watch out for in 2014. What are you working on?
Well, joint venture in Kosovo is the first thing. Hopefully from this meeting, one or two more joint ventures in Portugal. And on the drilling side, good results from Kovash Tungsten and good results from the Alvalade joint venture with Antofagasta and copper.
Well, so. Good luck with all that.
Well, we're going to make our own good luck.
You got a big in-tray.
We got a lot to do. That's yeah. Correct.
Paul, it's a pleasure. Thanks.
Jeremy, thank you very much.
Thanks.
Appreciate it.
Paul Kuhn, he's the president and chief executive of Avrupa Minerals.